Hello, I'm back. I can't believe I'm back so fast. Normally, it takes me a couple of days to recoup and try to come up with another idea. But this paper was pretty, so it was kind of easy. This is from that French Chateau Michaels paper, is the recollection brand. It's the brand they're selling now at $9.99 in the States. And I had made a card with one of these. Let me show you the paperback. It's this pack. I had showed it before. And it has all these pretty papers, a bunch of pretty tones. And I had made a card with this one. And today I decided to use that one. They look kind of similar. But the only reason that I wanted to do this is because I was involved in a swap. And I received this peacock. And I thought it would look beautiful with this paper. So that's the reason that I guess motivated me to make another card today. Because normally, like I said, it takes me a couple of days to recover because my brain can't work that fast. But this is what we're gonna do. How we're gonna do it, what we're gonna match up, I have no idea. I brought out a bunch of different dyes. To see what goes best. I even brought out a happy birthday die to see how I like that. I brought these out from LDRS. Again, we're just gonna play around with a bunch of stuff and see what ends up on this card. For sure, I know that this is gonna be my background. I believe this will be one of my layers. And that's all I know so far. So let's start by figuring out what we feel will look best. But you know what? I'm going to cut out a couple of these things first. So let me get the machine going and I'll be right back. Okay, so we're going to cut out our bases first. I already have my card base, which is great. It's 5.5 by 7, and we're gonna cut these panels out. I want to have, instead of the white trim, I want to have this blue trim. So we're gonna cut this one out. Maybe I want three. We're gonna cut this one out at, let's do a little bit less than five. And we're going to do the same in the seven part. So now we have that. So this will be our first panel, and it'll leave a tiny bit of white showing, which I like. And now we're going to take the pattern paper and we're going to do the same thing. That could have been my finger. We're also going to cut it, but this time we're going to go a little bit, maybe 4 and let's see. Let's cut it there. I totally suck with measurements, guys. I normally just eyeball. Where I want it. So, you gotta admit your weaknesses, right? See, this is a tad bit big, so we're gonna trim it down a little bit more. Maybe take out another eighth of an inch on each side. Make sure it's even. Okay. Let's try it now. Oh, yeah. Okay. See, I think that's pretty. And then with a teeny bit of the white showing here, I think that's going to look really nice. So we have our card bases done. And we're gonna put this to the side for a second. We might use some of that paper, so I'm not gonna put it totally away. And then we're gonna see what we do for the top part. So basically I gotta decide which one I wanna use. I might just cut them all out and then see what I like best. So, but sometimes you think one thing and then you end up doing a totally different thing. Okay. Now we have to think, what would we cut this out of? Which we might do that in gold. So that means these layers should be a different color. And we could even go as far as making 3 layers maybe. Yeah, I think we could get away with it. We can always do the white layer. We can do a gold layer, or we could do the blue layer and then a gold layer, which might look pretty. Okay. So, we might do, should we do this one gold or the middle section gold? I think this one, because this will be far enough away from the sentiment. And then we're going to cut our sentiment out. Will this work? I don't know. We're going to try it. Let me cut these out, tape them down, and I'll be right back. Okay, so I taped them off. And we're just going to start our machine. I should have done that off camera, but I didn't. Let's get that done. And we're going to bind our plate. So we're going to cut these out first. And we're using the Gemini again. So let's take care of that. And basically, I mean, if you get something like this, you're just going to kind of go off of the design. And then just see what looks best. Okay, so this is pretty. But we would have to see how it would play with our peacock. Which, that actually looks very nice. So, that has potential. Now let's try this guy. Oh, which also has potential. Let's see. Let's cut these guys out and see. This might be harder than I think, guys. But look how beautiful that looks together. And my swap partner did such an amazing job. On layering those pieces. I'll find out who makes that die. I think that's a Crafter's Companion die. If not, it's Anna Griffin. Okay. So we're going to do this. Let's try to pop out as much as we can. Okay. And then we have the eye left, which I'm not going to worry about now. So now we have to imagine this with another piece of cardstock and either that. War. That. Let's cut out some of the blues and then we'll see where we go. And maybe even the white circle. Just to see what looks best. So we can put these to the side and not worry about those guys. Of course, if I use this one, then I would have to use a different color for the font. We'll see. Okay. We're getting somewhere, right? We're making progress. That's what's important. Okay, so we're gonna cut this one blue. And let's see the size of this guy. Does it fit? Yes, it does. So then we will cut this one blue as well. And then these two guys will be in white. So we're gonna need a longer piece of cardstock. So let me just cut that. Normally I would try to be a little more careful, cut it the size just to conserve, but let's just run these through. I think we don't need this anymore. Okay. Let's push these to the side. Now let's see how it layers. And we may have to cut the white piece out just to get a better view of what we want. That's that size. Okay. Let's test it. We definitely need white. So I'm going to get another piece of white cardstock and just cut that out. Of course, I'm trying to always find my scraps, which I normally have available. And then I move one thing and everything goes haywire. Let's go ahead and cut these two guys out. And then we could decide what we like best. I think we're kind of ruling out the other one because I don't have anything else to layer with that color. I mean, with that dye. So the one from LDRS, although it's very pretty, it's out. Oh, I felt the move. Okay, let's run that through. Now the swap I was involved with was really cool. It was fun. And if it's okay with her to say, you know, where the swaps are coming from, I'll write it in the links. I'll ask her. But I don't feel right, you know, saying her name without permission. I don't want her channel is a channel and I'm gonna respect it. That's what I'm getting to. Okay, so we can do that and then do the peacock. Or we can do the same with the circles. And then bring this guy in also. So it's basically what looks good to you, which I'm kind of leaning towards the other one because the peacock is all fancy. I think we're going to use these guys. And again, I love using dimensions, but postal service has made that very difficult with the prices. So we're just gonna glue these down. So we're gonna start with our panels. And I'm gonna do one at a time because when I rush things, you know how that goes. You rush it, doesn't go well. So apply glue. You know, you could be kind of generous with this glue because you're gonna cover most of this panel up. But it also gives you a little time to move it, which is why I go for the white glue most of the time. This is Art Glitter Glue, and it's my favorite. You see, you can still lift it. I use it all the time. Just because it tacks on pretty quick, but it also gives you a little bit of time to adjust. And I think we're good there. It's fine. You're really not gonna see it. And if I don't like the way the white is, the way the blue is centered, then I can always trim it just a little bit. But right now it's good. Okay. So we're gonna do our next layer. And we're just gonna put that one right on top of the other one. So you really can't tell once you have that other layer, just because it's so pretty and it catches your eye. You're not really paying attention if you're a little bit off. Which, making videos, is you run that risk of being a little bit off because of the way you're positioned. Kind of hard to get it straight when you're right not on top of the card. And I refuse to show you guys my gray hair. Okay, let's see. I think it's fine. We could just leave that there. Okay, so we have that. And now we're going to add these guys. Again, we're just going to lay them flat because if you add too much dimension, you're going to have to pay for extra postage. Not only because it's going to weigh more, but even if it's you use thin cardstock, if you add dimension and it's a little bit higher, it could catch on their machines and it could destroy your card. So for them to sort it by hand, you have to pay the extra postage. At least that's what my understanding is. Okay, so we're going to do this. And then we're going to add this guy somewhere here, which he'll be our focal point. I mean, how can you miss him? He's beautiful. Okay, so we're going to start layering these down. I'm going to go with the smallest layer first. And we're going to try to center that as good as we can. Some people use rulers and all this other stuff. I just try to eyeball everything and makes it easier for me. Okay, so here we go. And we're gonna put this guy there, which gives us enough space for our peacock to grace the car. We can even bring it up more, which I like better. Okay, so that's what we have so far. And then we're gonna add our sentiment. Now we have to decide if we want it just straight or do we want it a little bit at an angle. And I guess that's all depending on how we want our peacock. If we want him here, oh, hold on 1 second, come on little guy, we can always put him on a little bit on the And then you just gotta step back and see how it looks good to you. Do you like it straight? Or a little bit off? I think I like it a little bit off because I am a little bit off. Okay. You can do this two ways. You can put glue on your hand, you can glue on your desk, on a piece of paper. I just thought just enough to secure it in place. Don't add too much glue because it's gonna go to the other side if you do, like here. But just add enough so you can make sure that it's gonna hold, especially in these delicate areas. You don't want them to lift or get snagged, especially when your recipient is taking it out of the envelope. So you gotta make sure those are laid down properly. So I think we're good. Just maybe a little bit here. And now we can add our sentiment. And I got a little bit of glue again. You guys know I use my adhesive eraser to remove that. And we're just gonna put this guy down. So he should be able, okay. Maybe there. And I think we're good to go. We have the happy and the Y, the H and the Y almost identical. Almost, not quite, but it's fine. And then we're gonna add our peacock. We can always go a little higher and do it like that. We can go a little lower. It's just you have to move it around to see what looks good to you. And I'm kind of leaning towards, I'm not really concerned about that, maybe towards that. I think that looks good. So we have to look at it and then we just gotta commit. Now, again, we can actually add him to a couple of dimensionals. If I had this die, I would have probably cut another piece and added here so I can bring him up just a tad. Maybe I could do it with paper. Let's see. Let me get a small piece of cardstock and see maybe if I can add some dimension with some cardstock. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut it, but I'm going to fold it in half because the layering might be a little bit higher, which will most likely be like that. Okay, so let's cut the part of his tail first. Doesn't have to be perfect. And then we'll cut a little piece for here. Okay, so I'm just gonna try to not, again, it's not gonna be perfect. We'll just cut it, rough cut, and then we'll come back and trim it out a little better. I'm kind of kicking myself for not buying that die. Okay, so we're gonna keep trimming it. You know, I'm wet. I don't know why I'm struggling with this scissor, but I don't know where my other one is, so. Okay. Okay, we have that. And now we're just gonna cut a little bit here. And then maybe trim it. I don't want to hurt our peacock. So, I'm going to continue doing this off camera because it's going to take a while. And I don't want you guys to be sitting here waiting. So, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm happy I paused you because that was even painful for me to do. So we have it all done. It doesn't look pretty. It doesn't have to. It just has to be effective. And if it holds everything in place, then we're good to go. Because you don't want it to go through the mail and get all dinged up. So we're gonna add glue to this guy here, to the head, obviously. Maybe the neck. And maybe some here might stick, I don't know. I'd just rather put more than less. Okay. So we're gonna see where we want him. And I think that's where I want him to go. And then we're just gonna hold him in place until he adheres. This one will require extra postage anyway, just because I added some dimension there. So just hold him down, make sure he adheres well. And then you have a finished card. I didn't think I would use it because I wouldn't want to get rid of the peacock. I have a second one though, but it's stunning. It's so pretty. You can add some gems to it if you want, to give it a little extra bling. We can get rid of that extra adhesive with our adhesive eraser if I could ever find it. I'm always misplacing it. Anyway, you guys get the idea. I've done it before. But that's it. It's very pretty. And I might add a gem on the eye. Maybe this color. I think I have some somewhere. And I think we're good to go. I think it's beautiful. So that was my inspiration. I was looking at it this morning and I'm like, oh, okay, maybe I'll do something with that. So I hope you like this video. And I'm gonna go through all my other swaps to see if I can make something else with them. And if I can and get inspired today, I'll be back. But I hope you like the card. I thank my swap partner for creating such a beautiful peacock. And I'm pretty sure the person who receives this card is gonna be floored. So that's my video for today. Have a great one, guys. Bye.